Welcome back, guys. In today's session, we are going to discuss two important concepts about Java threads and interview questions related to the same. So before we start looking into that, I just want to mention that I often create LeetCode solution videos in Java as well as Java J2E interview related videos to help junior and mid-level Java developers in their interview preparation. So I already, if you check my playlist, you already have a lot of important and good material about your Java interview preparation. So please check it out and subscribe to my channel. So my channel, if you are watching my videos, please subscribe to the channel. It helps the channel to reach out to more people. So let's look at the question that I was recently asked in one of my telephonic interview. So the question was that if we can call threads run method, why do we need a start method of the thread, right? So this is the question the interviewer asked. So basically, for example, here you can see that I have created a system out, and I am just printing the current thread's ID and name, and then I am creating a print thread object here, and I'm just calling a run method of the thread, right? So what is wrong with this actually, right? I can call this. So let's just call this and I will show you. So once we call it, it prints the main method, like main thread name, and it goes to the run method. And again, when we are printing the name of the thread, it is again printing the main thread, right? So this is the wrong thing, right? What we want to do here is we want to create another thread and separate than our main thread, right? And that thread will run by itself. It will not be part of the main thread. It will be there will be spawned another thread and it will run separately. So that is why we should not call run method directly, but instead we should always use start method, right? So now I will show you, when we call a start method, then a new thread will be spawned for this print thread, and it will create another ID and another name, right? So that is what we will see now. So as you can see, the main method, the main thread is called here. First thing is main thread here, and then as you can see, another thread is called here, right? This is another thread got created here basically. So similarly, if we actually now let me show you one more thing, like let's create another thread now, a second thread. So let's just call it a PT2, and we will just call the start method on PT2. So as you will see, this will create second different thread actually. So that is the important concept of thread, right? Because it should, we want to spawn different thread, not the, we don't want to run our thread in the same main thread, right? So that is why we should call start method of the thread and not the directly call the run method. So this is a question that was asked in one of my recent interviews, so I just thought of sharing it with you. So other question, other concept I wanted to discuss here is the joining of the threads, right? So for example, if we have let's just say, like, we have two threads, right? One thread for the discussion purpose. So one thread, what it does is it calls a RESTful web service and it fetches some data, and it just get the data, and then let's say it is storing into some database table or something, right? From in the database, it is calling some third party vendor, it is fetching the data and it is storing into database. And thread 2 has to start after the thread 1 finishes this process, right? Because it wants to create a PDF report, so it wants to read the data from the database table where thread 1 has, it has placed the data after fetching from the RESTful call. So in this case, the thread 2 cannot start before the thread 1 completely finishes, right? Otherwise it will not get the complete data in the PDF report. So how we can do that? So this is also one of the important concept of thread, and sometimes interviewer ask questions regarding that there are two threads and this kind of scenario, and one thread needs to start after the, let's say, thread 2 need to start after thread 1 is finished, right? So how we can do that? So here I created a small example for that. So here we have like one testing thread. So it just, you know, like it's not doing much, it's just kind of iterating in a for loop, and it is just let's say it is just printing its ID and name, and it is doing it like 5 times, let's say. And when we are actually, let's say, first I wanted to show you the actual scenario, and then we will see the join scenario, right? So let me just code like comment out this part so you will know better. So now what we are going to do is we are just printing the current thread of the main thread here, and then we created 2 instances of testing thread. And let's say I am just calling a start on t1 and t2 now, right? So now what happens, let's see after I do that. So as you can see, see thread 0, thread 1, thread 0, thread 1. So there is no sequence. So thread 1 basically is not waiting for thread 0 to finish, right? So this is not what we want. This is a wrong thing, because thread 1 we want to start after thread 0 is completely finished. So at that time the join method actually comes in picture, right? So now let's just comment out this part, and let's just now run this part of code. So now as you can see, after t1 start we are calling t1.join. So what it will do is it will wait the thread 1 to finish, and then only it will start thread 2, right? So that is the important concept of threads. So many times the interview questions come on this. So as you can see now, it only thread 0 is running first, right? See here, thread 0 is finished. It printed until like 5 times, and now after it is done, thread one starts after that separately, right? So this is the way you can solve this problem. Basically the problem that we were discussing, that thread 2 can start the report generation, for example, after thread 1 has finished all the bringing all the data and persisting into database, right? So this is how you can solve this problem. So interviewer might give you some kind of a problem like this, and they will ask you how you can solve this problem actually. So these kind of questions come during interviews for you know, either junior or mid-level Java developers. So please understand, you know, how the joining works in thread. So I already explained you, but you know, try to do some kind of examples. So if you look at the this is the API of Java. So if you look at the join, you know, it says that it waits for this thread to die, right? So it, which means that the next thread will only start after this thread completes. So this is the way you can join threads in Java. So I just thought that these 2 interview questions are you know, useful to you if you are preparing for Java interviews, for telephonic as well as you know, like in the initial screening rounds. So you know, please check out my playlist. You know, I have created a lot of Java interview related videos and coding exercises along with the examples and detailed explanation. Please check it out, it has a lot of good stuff in it. And please subscribe to my channel. You know, if you are watching my videos, please subscribe to the channel. It really helps the channel. Thanks for watching the video.